What up, guys? Chubsy here. Time for episode 4 of Speed Builder. Today we are doing the Turkish League. We're going to start off with the formation 3-4-3. Why? Because there's no decent left back or right back. So I've decided to just go straight through with these three, because you can get fairly pacey players to play centre back here, and one massive, huge motherfucker in the middle. Okay, first of all, we're going to start up with the reason for I'm going to have this manager. F. Rutten. Quite simply, I know he's Dutch, but all you need is him and he gives you 10 chemistry if your manager's in the right formation. So that's perfect straight off the bat. Now we have the goalkeeper, Demirel. That's how you pronounce it. 450 coins. No problemo, mias amigo. Similar stats to the likes of Neuer and Lloris. I forgot his name for a second there. Jesus. Reef handling lets him down, but you can live with that. Now for my centre backs, we have Lugano here. Goes for around 800 coins to about 1.2k. There's an informed version of him, and it basically bumps up his defending, dribbling, passing, shooting a bit more. Doesn't do much to his pace, so does make him a must get, only if you want to have him a bit more threatening. On the other side of the centre back, we have, you can either go for two here, you can either have Lucas Neal or Joseph Yobo. I prefer Neal because he's more rounded off in that kind of defensive area, and he's only 350 coins most commonly. He's got better defending than Yobo, bit slower, bit weaker heading, but he's more evened off, which is what I prefer, and 72 passing, which is perfect when you're going to have Alex just there. Now we have Setin, the slow one, but he's just there to be that big brick wall that nothing will get past. 80 defending, 86 heading, can ask for much more. Apart from the fact he goes for 1k coins. I think you'll find that with the majority of this squad, apart from my informed centre and midfield pair, that it is a very, very cheap squad. Perfect for people who are, you know, low on money, want to get a decent squad together, because these are very good players. I'm not going to lie about it. Now we have Emre with Alex in the midfield. Goes for 15 to 20k. I do suggest getting the regular of either of these two if you can't afford the informs. Inform Emre is only 5k, so there shouldn't be a problem there if you're affording the other players I've had in my other episodes. First of all, why am I going with these? They have both got brilliant playmaking attributes. 89 passing, 93 dribbling. 87 passing, 90 dribbling, and even 86 shooting. But these have both got very good long shots, fairly good at finishing as well, surprisingly enough. It's just that kind of, look at me, I'm an inform, I'm going to be a fucking beast anyway, no matter what my stats are. That's what I found out of a lot of inform players. Yeah, so you want to get these two inform. I suggest inform because it is the best choice. They combine well, they pass the ball around well, they can get a shot away. What else do you want? Nothing else. And then we have Mr. Alanzinho. Sounds like a bit of a rip-off name of Ronnie. Ronaldinho. But he's a bit of a gnome. 5'5", 850 coins, cheap as tits. Slow-ish, but he doesn't really seem it. Might be because he's a bit of a gnome. Passing 77, dribbling 82. Just another person that you can get out wide. Get out wide with Emre. And, you know, help support Simao. And, yeah, that's about it. On the right midfield, we have Mr. Hilbert. He's a bit more pacier than Alanzinho, but the two of them do both have four or five star skill moves, so that's always a good bonus. Not as good shooting, a bit weaker passing, but you know, he does that job a bit well to just keep the midfield a bit flatter and protect the back line on the wings. Now we have my two wingers. We have Simao and his countryman, Ricardo Quaresma. They both do the same job, 4-star skill moves, and they just absolutely tear shit up when they need to. You know, they just, you know, you get down the wings with them, you can cut inside, have a shot, cut back, and the good thing is, he goes for around 1k normally. I got him in my pack, and Maxi Mal, 650 to 1k. So again, that's another great cheap buy there for a well-known player who's top class. Then up top we have Niang, and Lama Lama Lang Lang. 900 coins, 82 pace, 82 shooting, 86 dribbling. What else do you want from a striker? Oh wait, 82 heading. Bang, tidy. He's a bit short, but he can still win balls in the air well. Okay, onto my bench. We are going to go off and get this man right here. Kivrak. I think he's the second or third best goalkeeper. He's around 300 coins, so you might as well just pick him up for that odd moment where this guy's going to be injured, tired, or you just want to give a break from having that guy in goal. Don't know why you would. Next up we have the centre backs. There's Joseph Yobo, who can play out on either side here or here, and Mr. Ferrari, who is pretty much the replacement hench to go in the middle. Oh Jesus, my bad there guys. Yep, basically Ferrari can go either side there or there, and it just works out perfectly for you. No, sorry, either there or nowhere else. Because 67 pace is going to let him down if you've got the likes of Ashley Young, Joaquin in form, tearing down the wing. You're going to get absolutely fucked up the arse if someone comes up against him. He's got good heading, and both of these go for around 1k each, so that's perfect. Next we have a replacement midfield duo. I think they both play for Besiktas, I think that's their team. And they do a very good job together, similar to the way Alex and Emre do. Just obviously not even half the way on their level, and they're going for a fair bit cheaper. 700 coins, 600 coins, basic stats for passing out on that. Just want to watch Ernst a bit because he's a bit sluggish on the pace. So you don't try not to charge up the field with him or expect to go on a high dribbling spree. I think Rodrigo has got a decent set of skills, so you can go on a little run with him if you wish. Next up we have Turan and Kazim Richards. I think that's it. I guess I pronounced his name. I think it's Kazim Richards, isn't it? Colin Kazim Richards, yeah. These two, basically, you can just stick them there or there on their own sides, just so you can keep that chemistry going and just keep them fresh. All that basically does is just mean you can have a more attacking approach if you want to play both Turan and Simao on the wing out wide. Very good when you overlap like that. But in other terms, him and Kazim Richards just play to fill in there. They're both cheap. Turan's about 800 coins, you can't go wrong. Just lower stats to Simao. Kazim Richards, 400 coins, not as good. 69 shooting, ain't a bad number, I'm going to say that, but it's not really what you really want from that guy on the wing. It's more just, I prefer playing him in the right midfield, just because he's better with the overlap. Now my replacement striker, Milan Baros. Basically, perfect replacement for Niang, just weaker shooting apparently, but he does finish a hell of a lot. Of goal, 13 and 24, can't go better than that. A heading 76, 80 dribbling, so he's good to get past players. I think he has 3 or 4 star skills, so he isn't the trickiest, but he can get past players well. Around a K, so there's nothing wrong with that. Okay guys, this has been my episode today. I'd just like to point out that these two are very key to how you play. You have to put all your play through Alex, but don't be afraid to lay it off to Emre and let him have a dig. Keep him on his left foot, his right foot's pretty atrocious, and you should be fine. I'll speak to you guys later. Peace.